has been significant. You can see how influential he is around all the other players.
Round one continues tonight with Collingwood playing Sydney at the MCG. The game will be live on 5AA. And Australian basketballer Ben Simmons has undergone back surgery for the second time in 3 years. Now checking 5AA traffic.
Afternoon, at only a crash on the road near Maud Street in the East Parklands. Wakefield Road is closed between Kettlewood Terrace and East Terrace till Monday. That's for the Adelaide Motorsport Festival. Speeds reduced around there. Busy at Queenstown for works. Oldport Road near Victoria Street. Slow at Ottaway. Grand Junction Road near Rose Street. With cameras, Kessler's Road, Power Hills West and Gorge Road at Paracombe. Dan Murphy's don't match, they beat prices. Corona Extra Beer, 355ml bottles, 24 case, $57 for members. And Sunday, choose to drink wise, T's and C's apply. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Now the 5AA forecast, partly cloudy this afternoon, partly cloudy tomorrow, 31. Sunday, a possible shower, 32. Mostly sunny Monday, 28. Right now, it's 29 degrees. Now let's check what's happening on 9 News tonight.
I'm Brenton Raglis. Tonight, a freedom bid by the southern suburb woman accused of the love triangle murder of her ex-wife. SA's flu surge and the protection available. The moon, Mars and beyond. Elon Musk celebrates an almost flawless launch of the world's biggest rocket. And we explain the new free program cutting your prescription costs. Nine News, your news, nightly at 6 on 9 and on 9 Now.
Streaming live via the 5AA Player app on DAB Digital Radio and on 1395 AM. This is 5AA, always Adelaide.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
5AA Afternoons with STacey Lee.
7 minutes past three on this beautiful Friday afternoon, and we're now live on the Foodland Supermarkets Facebook and YouTube live stream. And make sure you jump on because the smells in this studio already are really starting to waft through. You might be able to hear some noise going on as well because there's some sort of cooking happening because it's a Friday. That means it's time for this.
Welcome to Foodie Friday with Chris Jarma from Jarma's Kitchen. Thanks to Smeg and Parafield Airport Liquor.
Before I introduce Chris Jarma, I'm sorry, I do have some breaking news to bring you. We're hearing reports that there's a significant fire with explosions coming from a warehouse on South Terrace at Wingfield. That is a significant fire with explosions at a warehouse on South Terrace in Wingfield, and there's smoke in the area. So if you're around Wingfield and you're wondering what's going on in the sky and maybe there's some extra traffic around, that is probably it. I'd avoid that area if I was you, South Terrace at Wingfield. And if you're there, let us know. 8223 0000. What can you see? What does it look like? It sounds concerning. We'll make sure we bring you any updates on that throughout the afternoon as we get them. There's no explosions happening in here, but there's definitely something going on over
there.
Chris Jarma is here from Jarma's Kitchen. Hello.
Good afternoon, Stace. Really well.
And now you've brought a special guest in with you. We've got Carl Gallagher here, new recruit for the Crows all the way from Ireland. Hi, Carl.
Hi, how's it all going?
Good.
Lovely to be here. And there's obviously a lovely smell in the room.
And it's very topical because today I've been talking about your favourite smells.
Yeah,
surely so you have one,
It smells like I love the new car smell, obviously. And I buy this hair gel and it smells like bubblegum. And it's the only reason I bought that particular flavour because it's
bubblegum.
It smells like bubblegum.
Bubblegum.
So every morning I get to put that on my hair and it's a lovely smell.
That is hilarious. You are a gourmet chef. You make some beautiful food. You made pate today. You've got some bakery treat thing going on over there and you really like the smell of bubblegum.
Oh, I love it, yeah.
That's hilarious. Carl, what about you? Do you have a favourite smell?
I'd have to say probably bacon. Bacon frying up. It's a good smell. And over in Australia now, yous are big into your coffee, so a good smell of a flat white. It's lovely.
Yeah, I know at the restaurant when I open a bag of fresh coffee beans and you smell the beans, that is such a good smell too.
So good. Yeah, that's good. We've got better coffee over here, don't we, Carl?
I'd have to give you that one.
I brought Carl in today because it's St. Patrick's Day on Sunday. And so I've done a bit of a St. Patrick's colour theme with my dish today. So I've decided to do a pie floater with a bright green pea soup. So, and it's a quick, easy pea soup with minimal ingredients. All we've got is some finely chopped shallots, garlic, some parsley, some butter, some frozen peas, or you can use fresh peas if you prefer, and some chicken or vegetable stock. So I brought the thermo. I'm not a big Thermomix person.
Yeah, I was wondering what you brought in with you. I've never actually seen a Thermomix.
This is Linda's old Thermomix. So when she upgraded to her new Thermomix, we got the old one at the restaurant. I use it a lot at the restaurant to grind spices.
Yeah.
So, but it does cook things in there
it
as
does
well.
Everything,
so let's,
doesn't
let's
it?
Let's try and make the soup in there.
Okay.
So what I've got in there, I've got the butter, the shallots, the garlic, and the oil.
Is that what I can smell, the garlic? Because I just think every time my yaya or my mum cook, it starts with onion, garlic, and oil, and it's just such a good smell.
So then I'm going in with the chicken stock and my peas.
Your peas. Now, I'm interested that you said you've got frozen peas. Do you prefer frozen to fresh?
I love fresh peas, and I do cook those a lot, but I asked my greengrocer and I couldn't get any fresh peas at the moment, so I'm using frozen. But frozen peas is something you can always have in the freezer at home, and if you want a quick, you know, like a pea and ham soup, it you know, get some smoked bacon or smoked hocks.
Ooh.
And a pea and ham soup is great. So I'm going to hope this cooks in time.
Carl, I can see you watching on over there. Is this when Chris said, I'm cooking a pie that's going to float around in some pea soup, did you just think, what on earth are you on about?
I definitely had a few questions about it, but no, looking at it.
Yeah, we're having a chat with the boys trying to work out when pie floaters and the pie van stopped serving in Adelaide on North Terrace. And
they
I think
need
it was
to
like
get that van
mid-2000s or something. So normally a pie floater is something you'd eat 2 o'clock in the morning after a big night. Because they do look terrible, but this one here looks nice.
Yeah, it looks like something else at the end of a big night out, doesn't it, Carl?
Yeah.
So the soup is something you can make easily at home.
Yeah.
The pie, if you're not making your own pie, you can buy whatever pie you like.
Ooh. Oh, there's some beeping going on over there. Is that good beeping or bad beeping?
Yeah, now that's my timer, so I'm just going to crank that up again.
Oh, jump on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream, because this, I've never seen a Thermomix. That's pretty cool. So it does it all for you. Is it blending at the moment?
It's heating. I've got it on a very low stir.
Okay.
And then when I'm ready, it will blend it to a soup consistency.
So it can just do all of those things.
You can make risotto in there. You can make hollandaise sauce in there. You can make desserts in there.
Hmm.
The new Thermomix comes with a magnetic recipe that sticks to the Thermomix, and then you've got a bigger screen and it's got all the recipes in there. If you've got babies, when our kids were first born, this thing is the best. You know,
oh, you're making the food.
Pumpkin purees
for
the babies. Unbelievable.
Okay.
Now, the pie I've chosen is a very fancy pie. I get these from a friend of mine at the Village Bakery.
Oh,
these
yum.
Are lamb shank pies. And you can
Can
you smell that rosemary?
Oh, and
so,
looks very, very good.
Such good bakery. I used to live around the corner. It was dangerously close.
Ben was he's a baker, but he was a chef and had a very good restaurant back in the day. But he is an unbelievable baker. And he's taken his bakery to the next level because of, you know, his skills as a chef. And when you get to debut for the main Crows team, I bring those in after the game. So you might even get them after a sample game.
How does that compare to what you get after a game of Gaelic football?
Yeah, a bit different.
What do they feed you?
We normally would have some sort of beef brisket normally after a game, some
Ooh.
Sort of like that,
wow.
similar to what we
That's
would.
Not bad.
Yeah,
cool.
It just sort of depends where we're playing and what the facilities are like afterwards. But no, normally we're looked after pretty well. We'll go somewhere, maybe stop in a hotel, stuff like that. They'll have stuff rearranged, so we'll go in and have a nice dinner after the match, which is pretty good.
Yeah, nice. What are you putting in now, Chris?
Just a little bit of seasoning, salt and pepper.
And then what's that? Was that parsley?
This is parsley. That's going to help with some flavour, but also to get some extra green.
Oh, okay.
Soup.
We want it to be extra. Because when you said we're doing something in honour of St. Pat's Day this week, and then you sent a fancy pie floater recipe, I thought, what's a pie got to do with...
Yeah, it's not.
So it's the green.
Last year, on the show, I did a Irish pork stew, I reckon.
Ooh,
so yeah, very Irish.
And I actually cooked it up for the boys after training, because when Mark, I think it was during his first season.
Yeah.
Mm. Fellow Irishman.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Mark Keane.
So if we were training on St. Patrick's Day, I would definitely.
And how did the boys take to it? For the fans?
I like that.
Plenty of potatoes to go with it.
All right, we'll be back in just a moment. It's 16 past three here on 5AA, and I can't wait to see how you assemble all of this very soon.
5AA Mornings with Matthew Pantelis.
Hembo has just sent me a photo from the malls. A man arrested outside Rebel right now. He's got the handcuffs on. He's kneeling on the ground. Police officer standing over him. Hembo says this has just happened now in the mall. One arrest already. So Rebel targeted yet again. It clearly is a problem.
Matthew Pantelis.
Clearly there's a bloke who's been arrested who isn't up to speed with the news.
Weekday mornings from 9 on 5AA. Always Adelaide.
Stay safe and secure with Care Alert's GPS personal alarm. If an emergency happens, just press the SOS button to call for help. And at the same time, it will send your exact location via SMS to your emergency contacts. The Care Alert also has fall detection, and you can even speak through your pendant. All for just $379 with free programming and delivery included. Contact Care Alert on 1300 75 85 95 or visit carealert.com.au.
Due to thermal expansion, the Eiffel Tower can grow 15 centimetres taller in summer. You can harness the power of the sun too this summer with a 200-watt solar mat from Aldi for $229.
Sun.
Portable, easy to use and ideal for camping, it's special you can buy at the Aldi Camping Essentials Sale this Saturday.
Ooh.
Range differs between stores while stocks last. Aldi. Good. Different.
The BMW sale event is on now. Enjoy savings equal to the GST on select BMW vehicles across the range. Visit your participating BMW dealer today. Terms and conditions apply. Offer ends 18th of March 2024.
Morning, Debbie.
Oh, check the crack, not you again.
Sorry, job to do.
Don't wreck the house. I'm about to get it revalued.
I could knock 100 grand off the price dead easy.
But don't.
I did warn you with that crack in the cornice over there. Sorry.
Don't let cracks ruin your home. Adelaide Screw Piling will underpin your foundation, saving you thousands. Fully licensed, servicing all suburbs. Go to adelaidescrewpiling.com.au.
Hearing Australia's Hearing the Nation tour is coming to Adelaide, delivering free hearing checks for adults. Search Hearing the Nation for more.
Hearing Australia.
Conditions apply under the Australian Government Hearing Services Program.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
5AA Afternoons with Stacey Lee.
18 minutes past three here on 5AA. Just got a text from someone saying there's a bad accident at Marion and Sturt Roads. So that's all the message says at the moment, Marion and Sturt Roads. So if you're in that area, that's probably why there's a few cars around. So make sure you take it easy. Thank you for the text. 0448 08 1395 is the number if you'd ever like to send us a text. All right, Chris Jarmer's in the studio cooking up a fancy pie floater.
I'm ready to blend.
Okay, go on.
Okay, so it's going to make it. So now that the soup's cooked, now we want to just puree that. So we just...
Oh, my goodness. It looks like it's going to take off that thing. I'm scared of... This is scaring me a bit.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
So, she's all pure.
There is a lot of steam coming out of that thing.
Yeah, and then I'm just going to a little bit more butter just to
smells
enrich
beautiful.
It.
8223-0000. Bring us up. Tell us what your favourite smell is.
And I'm covering the top.
Yeah, good.
So we don't get pea
Thank
soup
you.
All over the studio.
Imagine that on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream.
Now, I'm going to take the lid off carefully.
Okay, all right.
Put it over here. A little bit of a taste test.
Okay. What do you think? Yep. You happy?
I'm going to...
Happy chef, that's good. That's a good start.
All right.
Okay, what are you doing now? Okay, he's pouring it into the bowls. Oh, okay, so you do soup first.
Yep. Okay. That's why it's called a pie floater.
Oh, yeah, not a sinker. Okay.
So we can go one or two pies. We'll go one.
Go one.
And then I've got some, whether you're a tomato sauce person or a, I have got some Beerenberg chutney.
Oh, yeah, beautiful.
Now.
The regular tomato chutney or the spicy one?
Just the regular tomato one.
I'm a fan of their, I think it's called their Uncle Steve's spicy tomato chutney. It's so good.
Now, are you going to try some or?
Yeah.
I'll do two.
Please. So do you even need to ask?
Plate up another one.
Never ask a Greek woman if she wants to eat.
All right, pie, bit of chutney.
Will you be trying it, Carl?
Yep, Carl is definitely
I'll have to. I've been eyeing it up here for a while.
You have to. Carl Gallagher's also in the studio. He's the new recruit from Ireland, Adelaide Crows recruit. Oh, okay, okay, yum. Okay, thank you.
There you go. Now, while you get stuck into that pie floater.
What's the etiquette with eating this? Do you bite into the pie or should I eat some of the soup? And here's Rowie, hello. He's
opened a Guinness.
He's cracked a Guinness.
We've got gags in here. How many of these have you necked, mate?
Yeah, pour it
go
in
on, Rowie, take a seat.
All right.
Thanks to...
Sorry, Carl, you've got to get nice and close.
Jamie and no Sam worries. From Pals.
Yes.
Of course, we had to match a nice Guinness.
Yeah.
Now...
Go on. All right, I'm going to crack mine as
Carl
well
would
then, shall I?
Definitely tell you that...
Ready?
A Guinness on tap is the best.
Yeah, definitely.
But
definitely.
These cans have a widget in them.
Yeah.
What's a widget?
It's a little plastic thing, and when you open the can... drops to the bottom or floats to the top, and that it helps create the creamy
creaminess. It'll rise to the top again once you're pouring it into a pint.
These are huge cans, can I just say. Look how big that is, the size of my head.
Now, you would have been weaned on this kegs, wouldn't you?
Oh, yes, definitely, definitely.
Does it truly put hair on your chest?
Yeah, well, that's what they always say.
Are you allowed a little one today? Or?
Oh, unfortunately not, maybe this weekend with St. Patrick's Day we'll have one.
So, classic Guinness draft stout. Comes in a six-pack, $30 for a six-pack. They're on special at Pals for $22.99 until Sunday. Now, you're going to try some pie floater, Rob?
It's actually,
yes, please.
That's really nice. I've always looked at Guinness and gone, I don't know if I like the look of that, but...
How good is it?
It's really good. Oh, do you have to let it sit? Mine's not in a glass. Am I drinking it badly out of a can?
Pour it in there, and then it'll go creamy on the top like this.
Oh, that looks good. Cool.
Pie's very, very good.
So is this lamb pie?
It's a lamb shank pie.
Lamb shank pie.
So we serve those at cocktail parties, and people love them. But whether you've got a lamb shank pie from Village Bakery or a Balfour's meat pie or a Villy's goulash pie, anything goes on a pie floater.
You're at my era. I mean, how many times at 2 a.m. did you woof one of these down your gills? Yeah. After leaving my place or the Oaks Tavern or in the city.
Does anyone have serviettes? Because I'm spilling it all over me.
My go-to was I used to love the beef and bacon pie. The Balfour's beef and bacon pie.
That soup's delicious. Mm.
And it's so, how quickly did you make that? And whether, you don't need a thermomix, obviously. If you were doing it in a pot, you just saute your shallots, garlic, add the peas, add the stock, add the parsley, and you've got a soup.
So this is quintessentially South Australian.
Yes.
What's the history of it? Who was the first dude to put a pie upside down in a super piece? Well, is it Irish?
Oh, the pie used to be upside down, wasn't it?
It did. It was upside down.
Yeah, that's right.
It's very new to me. I've never seen it.
But what a combination. It's a good combination.
Jono's brought in some serviettes if anyone wants any.
Google. He invented the pie floater. And we'll see unless one of our listeners knows.
And depending how drunk you were, was how hard the person that served you slammed the pie down face first in the soup, and how much of it went in your face and over you.
And Rowie, what's your favourite smell?
Yeah.
I can smell hops from the Guinness.
I know they're asking listeners what's their favourite smell.
Yeah.
What's mine?
Yeah.
Oh, my favourite smell?
You would have to be fish, wouldn't it?
Well, I think it's salt water.
Salt water.
Salt water,
just
beautiful.
Like you go to the beach, that smell... I heard you driving in, Stacey, talking about walking in winter and you can smell the weeds and the seaweed and all that. Yeah, probably. I reckon the beach. Salt.
The salt water.
Yeah.
Okay,
the
others
I probably can't mention.
No, don't.
Well,
don't get me in trouble. Come on. Wait till after 4 o'clock and you can say what you want on your show.
Have you asked Gags his favourite smell?
No, go on.
Yeah, so mine will probably be bacon. Fried bacon when you're waking up in the morning. Mm. Waking up to your mother, frying a bacon maybe
after a big
night out. Or before a match or something like that there. Or maybe coffee. Coffee over here is a big one.
Coffee.
I like the smell of coffee in the morning. I do too. Wakes me up a bit.
And what about the smell of Guinness, the hops?
Yeah, big fan of it. What do you think of the Guinness?
Oh, I love Guinness.
Yeah.
More, like I said to you out there, my daughter married an Irishman from Galway.
Oh,
Eddie O'Neill.
And
I've got a grandson, Rory O'Neill, and he's as pasty white as you. He's wearing as white as that shirt. And he's already weaned on Guinness.
Yeah.
No. And we call him our little potato. He looks like a little potato.
Do you like
He's the cutest
whiskey,
little
Irish
thing.
Whiskey?
Yeah, so it'd all be big. Like back home, Guinness, if there was, like over here, it's obviously not as big, probably because of the weather. So like we love Guinness, maybe going into a pub and the fire's on in the pub and you can have a lovely, because Guinness feels a bit warm and obviously it's not, it's in a cold glass, but there's just some feeling about it compared to a beer.
So we serve all our lagers chilled. The colder the better. So Guinness is meant to be room temperature, isn't it?
Yeah, so they pour it from the keg room temperature, but the glasses would be ice cold.
Almost
keep it in like nearly a freezer type of thing, just so the colder the glass sort of thing.
That's a good little one for you.
Do you know my dad's got a beer warmer?
A beer warmer?
From Austria.
What, and it's not his hands?
No, it's actually a test tube, and they put boiling water in it, and it hangs in the glass. So, but who would want to warm their beer?
No
way.
We should say that, of course, Parafield Airport Liquor has the perfect partner for every dish, and this week's matched booze to go with your modern version of a pie floater is the Guinness Draft Stout. And I've poured it into a glass. Look at that. If you can see on the live stream, look at that bit of froth at the top. It's beautiful.
Mm. Gives you really good pistachio.
Do they have anything like a Boilermaker in Ireland? Where you get like a beer and a shot of Irish whiskey or something?
Yeah. So like we'd have different drinks that would go hand in hand. Yeah. So like you'd go to a pub and somebody would have maybe a whiskey or a bourbon with a certain pint that they like sort of thing. So yeah, that would be common enough. Like obviously I wouldn't be the biggest fan of it, probably.
Have you had one of those? Boilermaker?
No.
Apparently it's a beer and a shot of bourbon on the side.
Yeah.
You go to a bar in America and you say, I want a Boilermaker.
I tell you what, I can drink Irish whiskey like mother's milk and I wake up in the morning and my head's like a Besser brick block. You can't get it off the cut. But God, how nice is Irish whiskey?
Do you like the smokier ones?
No, I just like the straight up and down Irish whiskey.
I like a whiskey, but I can't do the strong peaty ones either. I think the smokiness.
Baileys. What about Baileys?
Oh, no, that's what I mean. Baileys. Yeah. Baileys like Irish Baileys? Cream. Mm. Baileys Irish cream. Well, you wonder why I'm 120 kilo.
Do you just drink it on its own or with milk?
Straight up on ice.
Yeah, same. Yeah. I don't
just
like it.
Just straight up on ice.
Yep. You'd be a fan of the Baileys.
We have Baileys coffees back home, so they're very big around Christmas sort of thing.
Irish coffee.
Irish coffee. That's the big one. So you wouldn't, every time you enter a house around Christmas, you'd be offered a coffee, and it's not just ordinary coffee. There'd be
it'd be coffee with Baileys Irish cream in there instead of milk.
Oh.
Yeah, a bit like our eggnog at Christmas time.
I like that, yeah.
I'm going to try that tonight.
That's a nice way to start the Christmas morning, isn't it? Oh, well, this is beautiful. I'm really enjoying the pie and the soup is the hero here, actually, Chris.
It's nice and sweet.
I would agree with that.
I wasn't expecting to say that, but the soup's the
hero. It is a bit sweet.
Yeah.
Not sweet as in a sweet.
It's the peas. Peas are sweet.
Peas are sweet.
Yeah. Beautiful. Oh, well, thank you so much. That's Chris Jarmer from Jarmer's Kitchen for Foodie Friday. Thanks to Smeg and Pals. If you're building or renovating, your first choice should be visiting the Smeg showroom at Debney Distributors. Beautiful. You can taste the difference with Smeg and with Pals, the home of all of South Australia's great wines. Carl, can you hang around for a few minutes? Because we're talking St. Patrick's Day after this. So do you have a few extra minutes for
us? Yes, of course. Of
course. Awesome. Can't wait.
Local news and information first. This is 5AA News, always Adelaide.
Good afternoon, Mel Usher with the latest news headlines. A 14-year-old girl arrested in the southern suburbs has fronted court charged with possession of explosive instructions and extremist material. Explosions have been reported at a warehouse fire in Wingfield. Aged care workers will receive a pay rise of up to 28% under a decision from the Fair Work Commission. And in sport, round one in the AFL continues tonight with Collingwood and Sydney at the MCG. The 5AA forecast, partly cloudy this afternoon, partly cloudy tomorrow, 31. Right now it's 28 degrees. We'll have more news at 4 and as it happens on 5AA.
If you're packing up your family to travel across the land will treat you different in a Dave Benson caravan. There's never any roadworks when you're driving Aussie made, and you'll always find a park that's nestled safely in the shade. The magpies have stopped swooping, the kangaroos give way. You won't see a single mosquito at the end of each perfect day. And if the coppers pull you over, they won't wreck your plans when you tell them you bought Aussie made from Dave Benson Caravans.
Attention South Australia's green thumbs. Vasili's pop-up garden shop is blooming in Theberton from March 18th to the 24th. It's your chance to pick up all your favourite essential gardening treasures, from our renowned black grit, superfood, to Vasili's most popular planting mix. Shop online now. Select click and collect for Theberton and meet Vasili. Mark your calendars. Theberton, March 18 to 24. Visit us at vasilisgarden.com and enter to win a deluxe fruit and grape press worth $600. Vasili's, the key to regenerative gardening.
Mare.
A trip to the Adelaide Appliance Gallery really is like visiting an art exhibition. If you go there and you see the huge range of big name appliances on display, it's like walking through the Louvre in Paris. But you won't find the Mona Lisa. You will, though, find a team dedicated to making your life easier. They have the best advice, the best appliances, and the best offers on SMEG. Save up to 15% of special discounts on fridges, cookers, dishwashers and more. So you don't need a degree in dishwasher. You don't need to go on an oven odyssey or make a pilgrimage up Mount Washing Machine. You just need to drop into Adelaide Appliance Gallery. And trust me, I've been there. They literally have everything. They'll make your life easier with up to 15% off SMEG products at Adelaide Appliance Gallery, Paynham Road, St Peter's.
At Coles, there's great value hands down across fruit and veg this week. Like delicious 100% Aussie Hass avocados, just $1.30 each. Get great value hands down at Coles. Offer ends Tuesday.
Hurry, last days. 2023 TV and soundbar run out ends Sunday at Harvey Norman. Don't miss clearance prices across the entire 2023 range, plus bonus local delivery on selected TVs 65 inch and above. Samsung 65 inch OLED TV now just $2,795. Save more than $500 on Samsung S800B Ultra Slim soundbar, now $489. Super King size Hisense 85 inch TV now just $1,795. Hurry, Harvey Norman 2023 TV and soundbar run out ends Sunday.
Do we buy first or sell first? How much can I borrow?
CommBank can tailor a plan.
How much is my home worth?
What about an investment property? HomeHub can help you see what your house is worth and what you can borrow.
Hello, hello.
Wherever you are on your home buying journey, CommBank's lending specialists are with you every step of the way with all the support and tools you need. Search CommBank Home Loans today. Applications are subject to credit approval, conditions, fees and charges apply.
Live, local, this is 5AA, always Adelaide.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
5AA Afternoons with STacey Lee.
26 minutes to 4 here on 5AA and I feel terrible because Chris Jarman's still in the studio. We've got Carl Gallagher here in the studio, and Timmy G's just walked into the studio as well. You've replaced Rowie, and I'm sorry, boys, but I reckon I've got green stuff all in my teeth because I've just eaten your delicious pea and parsley soup. I don't know if you're on the live stream, you can probably see I've got green everywhere, but it doesn't matter. It's delicious. It's
old,
so good.
The old Ace Ventura, have I got something in my teeth with all the asparagus coming out?
I love that movie.
It's gold.
Carl, I want to ask you, you've come from Ireland, played Gaelic football over there. How long have you been in Adelaide?
Yeah, so I first came over for 3 weeks to get a feel for the Australian rules, and I came over in the start of November. Mm-hmm. So I stayed out for the whole month of November, and then when we got our 3 weeks off at Christmas, I went back home for Christmas and had a decision to make. And it was a pretty easy one with that time of year and the weather and stuff like that. So I said, absolutely, I'd love to come back for the next 2 years.
Oh, that's awesome. So it was an easy decision? Or
no, well, of course, it definitely wasn't. So all my friends and family are back home and my team are doing very well at the minute. So that was another thing. Mm. You have to weigh up your, are you going to leave and miss out on them getting a bit of silverware and stuff like that? So that was probably the hardest decision to make. And of course, you're still young, but I just seen it as an opportunity that in a few years, looking back, I could have really look back on it with disappointment that I didn't go for it. So,
yeah. What are the differences in playing AFL footy to Gaelic footy?
Yes, the rules is the main thing. It's the ball. The ball's the big one. Yeah. We play with the traditional leather. It's like almost like a soccer ball, you should know. But yeah, like the game itself is fairly similar, except of course there's a bit more contact in the Australian rules. It's the game back home is very similar to the integrated that they do over here. It's the
hybrid rules.
Yeah, the hybrid rules. It used to be on, what was it, every 4 years?
Can you throw the ball?
No, it's the same rules, close fist, handballing and all like that there. So, yeah, it's a pity they don't do the international rules
anymore.
Just
love the international rules.
Brilliant. I remember growing up as a young boy.
Yeah.
That was the first time I would have ever knew some of the big names. I remember Nat Fife and them, all them boys. And a lot of the Adelaide Crows boys actually played, which was pretty interesting. My sister's boyfriend, he played in it. Her partner, he played over in Adelaide.
Oh,
yeah, and did Ty Keneally actually go and play against Australia? I reckon he did, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Mm. And if I think I'm right, I think Jim Steins, he played for Australia against Ireland.
Oh, that's outrageous.
And he was born and bred Irishman, so yeah.
Classic. Wow. Now, I was asking you earlier, obviously there is a big difference in the ball you use. When's the first time you saw an Australian rules footy?
Yeah, so I think before COVID 2018, I was invited to do an Irish combine, and it was held by George Shawley. So it was a combine where scouts from Australia and Hamish, the Adelaide Crow scout, he was at that. So that's when I first got in contact with him. So that's it. So 50% of the combine would have been done with a Gaelic ball. So we would have did all the testing and stuff like that, the exact same as they do over here. But then we'd go into like match simulations. And I'd say the game was 60 minutes and 30 was with the Gaelic and 30 was with the ball. And we all looked at this ball, the Sharon, and was, what is this?
So how did you, because I know I played the Gaelic game, and it took me a while to sort of adjust to the way you kick it.
Yeah.
Because you can't kick it like an Aussie rules ball. Mm. You've got to kick it differently. It's a bit
around the body,
a hook. Goalkeeper.
Yeah, like a goalkeeper does it. So otherwise you're not going to get the accuracy that you need to get with the ball. So when you get hold of this oval looking thing, did you know which part of the ball to kick on?
Not for the first. I was trying to kick it almost like a rugby ball.
Yes,
as if the kickers.
So what did they teach you?
We would have just been, so how it would have worked with me was a group of boys who they thought there would be a possibility of them going to Australia. We would be invited down to do training sessions, and Marty Clark, who played for Collingwood, he would have taken them training sessions.
Cool.
So he shows you how to kick it and stuff like that. Yeah, and all the rules, and it's brilliant because you're meeting up with the best Irish players at the time your age in Dublin for the weekend, like, which is pretty fun.
There's a call. I was just about to ask, is there an Irish club in Adelaide?
Well, ask and you shall receive, Chris.
I was just about to say that,
because of course we're talking about this because it's St Patrick's Day on the weekend, and Darren Kerry's on the phone from the Adelaide Irish Club. Hello, Darren.
Well, actually, you can call me Dennis.
Dennis, sorry.
That's okay.
That's your nickname, right?
Irish club in Adelaide. Yeah, we do have an Irish club in Adelaide, as it happens, yes.
Do we have a lot of Irish expats in Adelaide?
It's next to the police club, isn't it?
Yeah, it's somewhere near the city.
Well, yes, it's 13 Carrington Street.
Me and Markeen were at it last weekend. We took
there?
A trip down,
did you?
Yeah.
Is that you, Michael?
Sorry.
It's Carl. Carl Gallagher's
Carl.
Here.
Oh, Carl.
Adelaide
Crows. Okay, Carl. Yeah, and Carl, you're fronting up again tonight.
Yeah, so we said we'd call down. It's open every Friday, so me and Mark said we'll call down tonight and help them out and see what the fun is down there.
The crack.
Wonderful. Yeah, the crack would be good. But yeah, so the Irish Club, 13, just when the William Street end of Carrington Street.
And will we have a lot of people celebrating this weekend, Dennis?
Well, that's certainly the plan. We have a fairly busy weekend. I mean, starting tonight at the club, the doors opening at 6 o'clock. We will have a couple of the Irish dancing schools performing about 6:45 for a short while. And then we're going to have some live music with a Dubliner, Malachy O'Reilly. And that will be followed by what we're calling a pint pulling competition. A pint pulling competition as to who might. Well, we've got these four people lined up, and I won't name names, who ordinarily wouldn't pull a pint.
Is that you, Carl?
I think me and Mark have been roped into it tonight.
I wasn't going to name names just in case. Just in case. So
do you have to do the shamrock on top of the Guinness? Is that what you got to do?
Oof, depends how good you are.
You just have to get a nice creamy head.
Okay. Mm. Yeah, have you seen when they do the shamrock on top?
Brilliant.
Well, the shamrock's there for the tourists in the main, to be fair. there's a competition tonight, and we're not sure who's going to win, but it should be good fun. We expect to be some wastage of Guinness, I think, because we're going to have a few attempts to sort of master the art.
Yeah.
But that should be good fun. And that'll pick us late into the evening, I would suggest.
Yeah, late into the evening.
It should be a good night.
Potentially early into the morning, that's for sure. Dennis, thank you so much. That's Dennis Carey, the Adelaide Irish Club. So, Carl, how does that compare to, you know, the celebrations when you're back home, I imagine?
Yes, the celebrations back home would normally be... So in my town, there'd be parades in every town, but obviously the big one is in Dublin. That's where a lot of tourists come in, and I wouldn't have been getting to much because this is when our football, same as here. You'd have football this time of year.
He's got to play tomorrow. He's got to be disciplined.
Yeah, so
is that why you're not drinking the Guinness?
He's pouring the pints. Yeah, I'm drinking them.
Yeah, I'm pouring them for the other boys. But yeah, no, it's a big celebration, of course, and it's great because there's always sport around that time of year. Traditionally, it doesn't happen anymore, but our club championship finals, so the All-Ireland from the clubs, not the counties, the smaller the clubs, they'd be on that day, so we'd massive. There could be thousands and tens of thousands of people at Crow Park watching that. Then they'd celebrate in the streets of Dublin afterwards. But we normally have matches and stuff like that, so which is great anyway. We still love to play football on that day, on St. Patrick's Day, because it's a great
and great for the crowds, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
Which is awesome.
Yeah, they might be a bit drunken. More drunken at the matches because it's St. Patrick's Day, but nah, it's great fun. Great fun.
You've got to play a game tomorrow. You're playing against Sturt. I think you're playing at Theberton Oval. So, where would they line you up? Do you know sort of where you'd be playing, forward, defence?
Yeah, so I would have been a forward back home, a half forward, but I've been slotting around the half back line at the time being. So, they've got a lot of successful Irish people playing off the half back. So, look, I'm open to play wherever. Like, I just want to learn the game as quickly as I can and stuff like that. So,
and so far in the pre-season, you've been able to deliver the ball beautifully, no doubt.
Yeah, so I'm getting a bit more hang of the kicking now. It was strange at first, but look, you have such a pedigree of coaches and stuff like that. You don't really have time to learn that many bad habits. But no, look, I'm enjoying it so far and have a lot of improvement to do. But
have you tried a torpedo yet?
Ooh, nobody tries to torpedo.
Or I was going to say, how do you go bouncing the ball? Because that's the nightmare.
Yeah, the bouncing, so hopefully you're doing it well enough to break away from men that you get plenty of bounces in. Yeah. But it's been fun, definitely. It's been challenging at times, but as I say again, you have coaches, you're in the right place to learn, that's for sure.
Yeah, very early on, I remember when Ty Keneally came over, he was running down the wing at SCG, and he was bouncing, and then he kicked it to himself.
Definitely. You see a few of the Irish boys
that
do that.
Flick up to themselves, and that's part of their game.
Because in our rules,
and old habits die hard, don't they?
Definitely. Mm. So bring them back, a bit of Irish flair. So
loved
it.
Oh, well, thanks for coming in and celebrating with us. We really appreciate your time and for showing me how to really pour a Guinness. That's
and you're not going to believe this. What? Tonight, I'm going to dinner with the Gallaghers.
You're not.
I am not this Gallagher, though. Grew up with an Irish family, the Gallaghers, and I'm off to have dinner with them tonight. So there you go.
I'm sure it'll be good fun.
Lovely mother and father, Mary and Thomas. Oh, there you go.
Very Irish.
Great. Very Irish. Beautiful. Well, Timmy, before you go, what's coming up on the sports show tonight?
Right. Well, Rowie and I are going to be on. So it's going to be excellent. Terrific.
Oh, that's something new. All right. Thanks for your time.
We got assistant coaches coming on to tell us all about the game, you name it. Treaders will be on. So it's an action-packed night. And, of course, Terry will give us all the tips for the weekend.
Perfect.
Get on board.
Sounds great. Looking forward to it. That's Rowie and Timmy G on your radio after 4. Carl Gallagher, thank you so much for coming in. Chris Jarman's on his way out as well with those pies. That was delicious. I'm going to finish drinking this Guinness. And then I'll be back in just a few moments to talk about what is on this weekend. If you're thinking about getting out and about, going to a last-minute fringe show, we're going to do a whip around of some of the best.
5AA is Adelaide's leader in sport. Thanks to Rossdale Homes. Check out our display villages throughout Adelaide and the hills. They're open all this weekend.
Pop into Cheaper's Chips this Easter for a happy Cheapster.
Cheaper's Chips.
Milky Bar or Kit Kat Easter Casket, always a hit at just $7.99 each. Look and feel cool with a 30% off all C&G summer clothing. And don't miss these cheap everyday deals. Lynx deodorant, two for $7. And pick up two 65-gram Cadbury favourites, a hot, hot buy at two for just $10. Live cheaper this Easter with Cheaper's Chips.
If you'll need a window,
and not just anything will do,
just call Statesman Windows,
back to redirect to you.
Nobody beats Statesman Windows, not on quality and certainly not on service. Windows, sliding doors, bifolds and more, made right here in Adelaide, factory direct to you. For windows when and where you want them, call Statesman Windows, states.com.au.
Windows when and where you want them.
One of the best things about South Australia is there's so much of it. Fortunately, getting from one side to the other is easy with Stateliner. Their fleet of modern, comfortable buses connect the city to the Eyre Peninsula and Mid-North, Riverland and Southeast, with many towns in between. Stateliner buses are equipped with toilets, air conditioning, they're wheelchair accessible, and you can even charge your phone. With 50% off for pensioners, seniors, children and full-time SA students, let Stateliner do the driving for you. Book today.
The BMW sale event is on now. Enjoy savings equal to the GST on select BMW vehicles across the range. Visit your participating BMW dealer today. Terms and conditions apply. Offer ends 18th of March 2024.
When you buy from Southern Steel Supplies, you're buying from a company forged right here in SA. For over 40 years, Southern Steel Supplies has supported those building our great state, from major construction projects to DIY around the home. If it's steel you need, Southern Steel Supplies has it all, including processing and delivery. Southern Steel Supplies, Lonsdale, Murray Bridge, Gawler and Renmark. southernsteelsupplies.com.au, the South Australian Steel Company.
$50,000 sitting in the bank doing nothing much? Interested in a direct mortgage investment? You could be earning 10% per annum paid to you monthly. That's right, 10%. Angus Securities has provided mortgage investment opportunities in South Australia for almost 25 years. Call 1800 010 800 to discuss this investment offer or visit the Flinders Street office. Investments are not bank deposits and there is a risk you could lose some or all of your money. You may receive lower than expected returns. Read the PDS carefully to decide if the product is right for you. AFSL 232479. Visit Angus Securities to access further information, including the offer brochure and TMD. 10% per annum fixed interest paid monthly. You're better off with Angus.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
5AA Afternoons with Stacey Lee.
12 minutes to 4 here on 5AA, and it still smells beautiful in this studio from that pea buttery parsley soup that Chris was cooking. It's got me thinking about your favourite smells. Make sure you join the conversation. 8223 0000. I've got a few more minutes for a couple more calls. You've got to be in it to win the family pass to Wallace Cinemas. Give me a call and let me know what your favourite smell is. 8223 0000. I thought we're heading into the final weekend of Fringe. Maybe you haven't got out and about just yet, or maybe you have and you're thinking, I'd still like to see one last minute show before it all comes to an end. Let's do a quick rip around to find out what's on this weekend. Have to go to Michael Griffiths. He's one of Adelaide's own performers and he's got a show on this weekend. It's a Sin. Hello, Michael.
Hello, Stacey Lee. How you doing?
Good. Tell us about your show, It's a Sin.
So it's Pet Shop Boys songs with a string trio of incredible local string players and a kind of a little bit of a nostalgia about what it was like to come out in the early 90s before the internet and before marriage equality. And it's kind of lighthearted and heartwarming. But, yeah, a bit of 90s nostalgia and Pet Shop Boys.
Oh, beautiful. All right, tell us where it is and how much are tickets?
It's $39 on Friday, Saturday, or $35 on Sunday, if you feel like a little bargain. And it's 7 p.m. in the Garden of Unearthly Delights in the beautiful Spiegelzelt, which is on my home run. I've been there for a couple of weeks. It's such a great time. Oh, it's a beautiful tent.
Beautiful. Oh, well, thanks, Michael. All the best with the final weekend.
Thanks so much, Stacey. See you soon.
See you. Michael Griffiths there. Let's go to Katrina, the real WOG wife. Katrina, hello.
Stacey, how are you, babe?
I'm good. How are you?
Fantastic.
Now, you and I are allowed to say that because I'm Greek and you're... Are you Italian?
No, I'm Greek too,
You're Greek too!
Oh, my God.
Tell me about your show, Katrina.
So it's my one-year vow renewal with my husband, but he doesn't show up, so I'm looking for a new husband so someone could get lucky. And I will teach you how to strengthen the muscles in your punani using Pilates and my yoni eggs. And let me tell you, Stacey, it's not just a Greek experience, it's a multicultural experience because we are performing in a Mongolian yurt at the Migration Museum.
All right, there you go. Where is Migration Museum and how much are tickets, Katrina?
$24, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, 6:30 p.m.
Okay, beautiful. Well, have fun. I hope you find the new man of your dreams.
Thanks, babe. Love
you. Love you too. Katrina, the real wog wife there at the Migration Museum. Let's bring in Gemma Caruana. She's got a show this weekend called Gala Gala. Hi, Gemma.
Hello. How you going?
Good. Tell me about your show.
Yeah, so my show is a comedy cabaret called Gala Gala. It's called Gala Gala because that was the nickname bestowed onto me by my immigrant grandfather because I was a very noisy child, the loudest in the family, in fact. So it's a comedy cabaret from the perspective of an elder sister, high achiever, perfectionist, people pleaser with anxiety. So if that sounds like you, maybe it's the show for you.
Yeah, it's very relatable.
Celebrating loud women and why and when do we shrink and how do we get back that noisy little bird within us.
Oh, beautiful. And you won a Fringe Award yesterday. Congratulations.
I sure did. It was for emerging artists. So, yeah, it was a weekly Fringe Award. Very pleased about that one.
Oh, that's awesome. Okay, so tell us, where is Gala Gala and how much are tickets?
Yeah, so you can find Gala Gala this weekend at 5:20, that's Saturday and Sunday, at the Migration Museum on Kintore. And tickets are $28, but your listeners can use the code GALA20. That's GALA20, and you can get $20 tickets.
Oh, beautiful. Thanks so much, Gemma. That's really generous. Thanks for your time.
Awesome. Thanks so much.
Gemma Caruana there, Gala Gala, also at the Migration Museum. 4:08 here on 5AA. Still have some time to take some of your calls. 8223 0000. We're talking about what your favourite smell is. Here's a few ideas from some of my lovely colleagues in the office.
I really love the smell of freshly mown lawn, especially when it's slightly cooler, a little bit of rain on the way, freshly mown lawn.
My dog's paws. Smells like cheesy Doritos.
My niece, the smell of her head. It's amazing. If you smell a baby, you know what I'm talking about.
Favourite smell would be walking into my mum's house and smelling some traditional Greek cooking that she's been working on, slaving over, 93-year-old that she is, over the last few hours. Maybe some roast or something like a spanakopita, or she makes killer pizzas as well.
Oh, stop it. Yum. Yeah, that's got me thinking about Mayaya's lukumades, the Greek donuts, the fried Greek donut balls with the beautiful honey syrup drizzle on top. That is just the smell of my childhood. Oh, so good. Join the conversation, 8223 0000. I'd love to hear what your favourite smell is. I've got a text message here. Someone says, the best smell in the world is a pine forest after rain. So fresh. Oh, that smells amazing. Yes, that's perfect. 0448 08 1395 is the number if you'd prefer to send a text. I've got a bit of an update on the story I brought you earlier, Wingfield Fire. The MFS has issued an advice level warning for that. It's a scrap metal fire on South Terrace in Wingfield. The MFS says it's producing a large amount of black smoke and it's drifting in a northwest direction. So they're saying people residing nearby should shut the doors and windows until the smoke has passed and avoid driving in the area until smoke has reduced. Smoke can affect your health, as we all know. If you're having trouble breathing, make sure you seek medical attention from your local GP, or if you have severe symptoms, call 000. The MFS will be updating throughout the afternoon, so stay here on 5AA and we'll bring you updates in the news throughout the afternoon. But that fire is a scrap metal fire on South Terrace in Wingfield, so make sure you keep an eye out for it if you're in the area. And the smoke is heading in a northwest direction, so that's why there's some smoke if you're in Wingfield at the moment. I also just wanted to reiterate that other breaking news we had this afternoon from South Australia Police. A 14-year-old girl from the southern suburbs has been charged with possessing explosive instructions and possessing extremist material. These are terrorism offences. She appeared in the Adelaide Youth Court today, and then she was bailed, so she'll be reappearing in court in April. Police say it's an offence to possess extremist material in South Australia. It's also an offence to possess explosive material, material that directly or indirectly encourages, glorifies, promotes or condones terrorists' acts. If you do know anything, make sure you call the National Security Hotline. That number is 1-800-123-400. But that's pretty concerning. A 14-year-old girl from the southern suburbs arrested on terrorism offences. That breaking news there throughout the afternoon. As always, like I say, we'll keep you updated here on 5AA in the news. So make sure you stay here on the station. Thank you so much for joining the conversation this afternoon. I think I'm going to give the Wallace Cinemas family pass to... We had Joy. Joy rang up to tell us about some issues she was having with her phone. So we'll give Joy the family pass to Wallace Cinemas. That's four tickets for nothing. Make a day of it. Catch a movie this week, Mitcham, Mount Barker or Noarlunga. Go to wallace.com.au for any session times. Thank you so much for your company this week. I've really enjoyed chatting with you, and thank you for joining the conversation to everyone that's given me a call to talk about anything we've been discussing here on the afternoon's program. Thanks to Jono for his help producing. I will see you next week.
Discover the magic of the Murray River and Riverland with Holiday Wonders. Our latest 3-day getaway offers the river's